So in this video, I want to go through when you are developing UI for Unity, how you can make sure that your UI is adaptive. What does adaptivity mean? It means that when you switch to different aspect ratios, your UI stays intact. If you look at the game screen here, when I change the aspect ratio, you will see in certain aspect ratios, things kind of mess up. It gets even worse when you do free aspect. You will see at certain sizes elements overlap with each other and things really don't look pretty. Even if I have say a certain aspect ratio, if I were to shrink the size of the UI like that, this kind of can mess things up also. Or say if I were to do a 16:10 aspect ratio, if the screen is big, you will see here there's no problem, but when I shrink screen, then everything starts getting clumped together and then I'll get real problems. Okay, so the easiest way to rectify this would be just to find your canvas and then to use the canvas scalar element. And then from here, what you can do is just do a scale with screen size, and then you can find an appropriate resolution for your screen. And you gotta play around the numbers a little bit, but if you get the right numbers, then when you start scaling the size of the screen, this retains the proportions of the screen, or rather it retains where the positions of your elements are. This is more of a hack than a fix though, because what it does is it fixes the screen size to a certain resolution. So then if you were to change the aspect ratio, you will still see in some aspects the elements will get out of place. So when you have phones that are very small, the aspect ratios can differ by a lot for very small changes in the width or the height of the phone. So for example, some phones are fatter, some phones are thinner. So if you're developing for phones, you may find that this can become an issue and the canvas scalers really are not the solution. So the other alternative, the non-hacky alternative, would be to apply a couple of tricks. They're not really tricks actually, they are actual tools that are used that allow designers to develop UI elements that are responsive or adaptive to different screens. One of the most important things and the main thing we'll explore here is basically this little anchor that you see here. Every element that you see in Unity has an anchor associated with it, and then you usually try and place the anchor nearest to one of the nine places, either the sides or the corner, to where the element is. So for example, here my fruit title, because it is closest to the top left corner, it's good practice to put the anchor there. But this is not the whole story. The best way you can, the best thing you can do with the anchors whenever you develop a UI screen is to always split the anchor. This is if you're not planning to use the canvas scaler to adapt your canvas to different screens. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to split the anchor. I'm going to set the left, top, right and bottom to zero. Okay, so what we are doing when we split the anchor like that and then set the left, top, right and bottom attributes to zero is that we are apportioning a portion of the screen to always contain this element. So for example, here you will see after I split the anchor and then I set the left, top, right and bottom to zero, you will see that when I scale the screen, the fruit always takes up the same amount of space. Okay, so now I'm just doing it for one element, so you don't really see the results, but once you do it for everything, you will start to see this kick into effect. Another thing that you want to do is whenever you do this and you're using image elements, meaning whenever you split the anchor and you use image elements, you want to check preserve aspect, because sometimes if you don't do this, when you stretch the screens to when you stretch the screen or when you squeeze the screen to certain proportions, you may find that your elements will get stretched. Like for example, this is really minor, but you can see that the fruit text gets stretched a little bit. If you change the aspect ratio here, I think this will make it a lot more apparent. Let me uncheck preserve aspect, and then you'll see that the fruit here gets really distorted. Okay, so this is the first principle or the first trick. Is to split the anchor and then set everything to 0, 0, 0, 0, with the anchor, the four corners of the anchor apportioning the portioning out the part of the screen that you want the element to be at. Second thing, okay, I'm going to split the anchor for this disclaimer element here very quickly. So I can show you what the second thing that you want to do is. So you'll see disclaimer, inside disclaimer here, there's text, there's a text element. I'm using Text Mesh Pro here. So the problem I have is that when I, because now I have split the anchor for this and I've set left, top, right and bottom to 0. When you split the anchor, you will find that the properties here change. So before the anchor is split, you will see it's X, Y, width and height. But then once you split the anchor, you will find that these properties change to top, left, right and 0. Alright, so once I split the anchor, you will find that this element here actually changes in size, but the text doesn't change in size. So this can cause issues where the text overflows out of the container. So if you were to encounter this issue, so usually for text elements, what I like to do is I like to parent them under the container that they are in, and then once I do that, I like to stretch the anchor of the text element to so that it covers the entire parent. So before the anchor was in the center, and then I'm gonna stretch it out. And then again, I'll set the left, top, right, and bottom to 0. So when I do that, you will see that the text kind of still, it is able to change the way it's laid out depending on how much space there is in the element. But the problem is that firstly, it kind of overflows the element still. And this is because when you stretch the element, you have to not give left, top, right, and bottom 0. You gotta increase the value a little bit so that there is a little bit of margin between the edges of the parent and the text element. And you also have to check this thing called auto size. What auto size does is that it allows the text element to change in size depending on the parent element. So it's really useful feature. You may have to change the minimum maximum size of your auto size options. So if you are using, I'm using Text Mesh Pro here, but if you want to use the regular text element, the auto size option is available for you too. So this is not something that's exclusive to Text Mesh Pro. So the last trick I want to show you is when a lot of people assign backgrounds, what happens is that they will just increase the width and height of the background over a certain size, over the size of their canvas, so that the background is always covered. But this can still lead to certain scenarios where, okay, my screen is not large enough, so I can't really stretch it big enough that you can see places where the background doesn't cover. But if I were to stretch it any further, you will see that the background will fail to cover my entire screen. So with such instances, what we do is, one thing you can do is, of course, you just make sure that you stretch the element, and then again you set the left, top, right and bottom to 0, so that no matter what happens, the background always covers the entire canvas. This may sometimes cause your image to be stretched. So if I look at my image here, the image itself, I forgot to set this before the tutorial. So usually the image type is simple. So what happens is that when you stretch the image and you do not preserve the aspect, you will find that the image is stretched like that. But if you do not want the image to stretch, you can always use image type tile. And then what this does is this repeats the image multiple times instead of just stretching or shrinking the image. And this is really useful if you have a tileable image. So I have a tileable image right here that allows me to multiply, or rather repeat the image across the width or the height, and then have the pattern not appear stretched as a result. Okay, so the three tricks here are, number one, that you always want to split the anchor and then make the anchor outline the portion of the screen that you want the element to be at. And then the second trick is whenever you have text, if you're putting the text in a container, you want to stretch the text element, and then you want to enable auto size. And then third, of course, is the tiling trick. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to apply all these tricks that I just introduced to the entire screen. And then what you will see is that when I scale the screen, you will find that everything becomes responsive. We're kind of halfway there, right? Because I haven't applied everything to the whole screen, so let me just do that. I'll fast forward the video and then you can see the results of this. So now as you can see, once I properly split the anchors and arrange them appropriately, you will see the screen looks a lot better. Still needs a little bit of work, but it kind of looks pretty okay across a lot of different resolutions. And for the rest of the resolutions where everything still doesn't look exactly okay, it's because I gotta find the right proportions for them on the screen such that they look good in such a screen. But you will see that everything looks a lot more acceptable now. You don't see the background cutting off, or you don't see some elements overlapping each other, and that's because we have split the anchor for all of these elements so that they only always occupy a certain percentage of the screen.